Well, his corner was pretty urgent after round one. A little bit lackluster there in that opening round. He has certainly picked up the pace here, and as a result, he has taken control of this second round. Hook to the head lands flush there by McGregor.
Oh!
Hand speed, man. McGregor going for the head kick. He misses there. Trujillo gets another takedown. He's one of the better takedown artists in this featherweight division.
Excellent movement on the ground here. Always trying to better his position.
No!
McGregor gets back up again. Well, he has landed some good shots tonight, Joe, but as yet, he has been unable to string together any solid combinations, and that has served to keep his opponent in this fight. So let's see if he can change up the tempo a little bit with his strikes and try to put together a combination that is more damaging to his opponent.
Oh, he tagged him!
What is that?
His feet again. Amazing.
My ass fell backwards, 360. I spun around like, what?
Seconds to go.
Another takedown attempt here. All right, so that's been the story in this one as he secures yet another takedown. And even though the opposition is doing a pretty nice job getting back to his feet quickly, he doesn't stay there for very long, continuing to get planted on his back. Round three next.
So the round comes to... Yeah, three. Final.
Third round underway.
Not this many bullshit points.
Big power shot there. Unable to connect with the right hand. Blocks the shot. Straight punch. Oh!
He killed me. Get the fuck out of here.
Let's do it.
And here's the end.
McGregor.
Now we go into
bullshit ass game.
Yo, the whole time I was trying to pin this shit, I was like, you know what it is? I noticed when you said it, that it mattered on stamina.
Yeah.
Oh, the first one too.
Yeah, the stamina, that's why I couldn't do any submission, because I was tired as fuck.
I was monitoring my stamina just in case you pull that shit off. I'm like,
and we are live and underway here at the Honda Center in Anaheim, California. And how about the buzz in this arena and just the sheer volume from these fans as Conor McGregor makes his return here tonight. Now, how will he approach the early portions of this fight? That is the big question. We know he's had some quick finishes in his UFC career, but a lot of people think he'll want to feel this thing out and get his feet under him early.
Oh, huge left shot.
Oh! Abel Trujillo sensing the finish here. Now goes in and secures the takedown.
Back to half guard. Look, he's got an arm triangle here.
You can't escape me now.
He's carrying the arm, clamps it down. He's got to get that leg free. Hop over to the other side. He's got it. Now he wants to rotate to apply pressure. He's got it. This is it. This is it.
Damn it, it's so hard to press.
Stunning, and he really made it look easy.
Too much head damage.
Great job in establishing that submission.
Ready?
That is bullshit. You just spam the shit online.
Pacific time zone. We get underway here at the Honda Center in Anaheim, California. Good to have you with us for a night of UFC action. Well, how about these Irish fans and their support of the superstar Conor McGregor? Better get in your seats early because McGregor is a notorious fast starter. We'll see if McGregor can get another early KO. And busy as he looks to improve position here. Joe, your thoughts on what we might see here early?
One thing to keep an eye out from Conor McGregor are his kicks. Very unpredictable, very creative with his kicking technique. Good punch.
Oh! Huge right hand!
He's definitely hurt.
Nice defense there. Huge block. Just missing on the high kick there.
damn it, that Hammersmith bullshit. Oh,
what a leg kick. Vicious combinations. Oh, he missed that kick. A big kick.
This game is so random. Whenever you get knocked out, like, I didn't understand it.
You gotta get it.
Holy shit, this is rough.
They hated Esco. They hated Escobar.
This is like, you gotta play your cards right.
I'm still here. Dave East, talk that talk. Streets need that. NYC, LA, Chicago, Detroit. The whole world. Let's get it.
I had a basic plan, get out the projects and never look back. Cause still smell the aroma from when my uncle was. Between homies, better yet brothers, they used to spend the night with each other. They moms was best friends. One name was Anthony, the hood called them Aunt Live. Kept his pistol on him, so he bought a bigger pant size.
This game is fun, I can't
yeah, it's fun.
I would play this shit if I, like, if, how much is this game?
I don't know. You can get it like 30, find it used.
All right, coming up next, it is a welterweight showdown between.
There's no like season pass to this or
nah.
Oh, my phone.
The tick.
First round, you ready? You ready?
Well, always great to be back on the left coast as we get underway here at the Honda Center in Anaheim, California. Great to have you with us as always. A pro dating to 2001, here is the veteran Nick Diaz, former UFC title challenger. 13 wins by knockout, another 8 by way of submission. You know the book on Nick Diaz. It's going to be punches and punches, but if the fight does hit the canvas, you've got to protect yourself. We'll see how it goes for Nick Diaz in his much-anticipated UFC return tonight. Gracie gets caught with that punch. He's got to figure out a way to get that guard higher, Joe. All right, first round is underway, and you know what to look out for here. The powerful overhand punches. That is a big part of his game plan. Every time he makes this walk, it is his go-to punch. We'll see if he can find a home for it early tonight.
Kick! He heard him. He is stumbling.
Some of that through Joe, this shot is blocked.
Goes for oh, you fucker! Whoa!
Takedown!
Under 3 minutes now to go in round one.
Oh, he got reversed. Nicely executed sweep, winds up in guard.
Gracie gets up, but he looks dazed and confused. Oh, he moved right into the kick there. A kick to the head lands, and he's shown a susceptibility to that in fights prior. You can't lean into those power shots. Let's see if he can circle out and make the adjustments here.
Nice takedown. Nick's up to his feet again, and he's free.
Oh! What? That one appeared to stay.
Get up. Why the fuck is it low?
Oh, he's blocked.
Get up. No, for fuck. Do it. Save my ass.
Now goes in and secures the takedown.
Arm triangle. He's looking for the arm triangle here in side control. And what he wants to do is, he wants to push his opponent's arm to the side, trapping it in place with his neck. Then he wants to shift his weight, shift his hips down, press his weight down, clamp a hold of it, and squeeze for the tap.
I don't understand this game.
Stunning.
We have like an even amount of stamina.
What happened? Oh, your head damage. Apparently you took damage.
Want to tap, went to sleep.
Yeah, great job executing the submission in that fight, Joe. Really excellent
work. Yeah, I'm just saying, honest now. Now we go inside the octagon. I need to like, look up in this game, like, how does the submission work?
Yeah, I didn't know the knee part.
It's so random.
And we are underway.
It's
Nick Diaz is extremely technical on the ground, but it's not that often that we see him take the fights there. He usually prefers to turn things into a boxing match. His punches, some of them don't look that hard, but they can knock you out.
That one hurt. Joe, what are you looking for out of him here in the early going?
One thing to keep an eye out for from Nick Diaz in this fight is his left hook.
Working on a single leg here. The takedown is not there.
He got tagged there.
Oh, landed it. Great kicks there.
Welcome to the jungle.
Landed a big kick there. Kick.
He's teeing off with some vicious shots.
Yeah, first takedown attempt is there.
He moves to stacking him now. Oh!
Diaz gets caught with that punch.
How did you get on top of me when I took you down?
Now he's in full mount. Yeah, that did hurt. You saw the wince.
Oh.
Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy.
Just over 2 minutes to go in round one.
Fuck. I can't do shit here.
Gracie gets absolutely melted by that head kick. Attempt the front kick there.
Man, we got tagged.
He's got him hurt here.
Look at this, takedown!
Wow!
The kick lands and he's down.
Oh! Secures the takedown.
We got for the arm. We got for the arm. He's got the arm here. Now he's going to throw his leg over. Turns the hips. He's going to sit back. And he escaped the arm bar.
30 seconds now going around.
He worked that time.
20 seconds now. High kick! Straight ahead.
Damn it.
So he heads back to the... Round two underway.
At the end of that round, his opponent was clearly hurt. He's going to look to start this round off fast and try to pick up where he left off. Nick Diaz has perhaps the best cardio in the UFC today. A regular triathlon competitor, he's a black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and has world-class boxing skills. It appears a cut has opened up on his cheek.
See the total strikes.
Whoa! This could be it right here.
Man, has his chin been tested early.
Dad, I can't even lift you up. What the fuck?
Well, he has landed some good shots tonight, Joe, but as yet, he has been unable to string together any solid combinations, and that has served to keep his opponent in this fight. So let's see if he can change up the tempo a little bit with his strikes and try to put together a combination that is more damaging to his opponent.
Oh, both men exchange.
Well, he gets cracked to the head there, Joe. He continues to be vulnerable by leaning.
Oh! How the fuck did you kick me? I kicked you first.
That's it. He's out. He's out. The fight is over. Wow.
That is trash.
And here's the end.
I kicked you first.
Bruce Buffer has the official.
Fuck.
That is bullshit. I kicked you first. Get the fuck out of here.
I've seen him, like, he fights in the UFC a lot of times, and then he's on a Spanish channel, too.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they have, like, these... You ever seen the challenge that was on MTV?
They
have some crazy shit. It's called The Challenge, where they have to do some, like, stupid shit, like... Oh,
Silent Library?
Huh?
Is it, like, Silent Library, or no?
No, it's like, you know the people who did, like, Real World or whatever, right?
Yeah.
You know, those people had, like, a competition game.
Wow. Crazy.
Yeah, so... It's like a competition.
Alright, coming up next, we get to this middleweight
shit bout
between Michael Bisping
and...
So, they have a Spanish channel for that. And he's on there.
As a host or what?
No, as a participant.
Oh, okay.
He won a silver medal in freestyle wrestling in the 2000 Olympics. Now he is the UFC middleweight champion, the soldier of God, Yoel Romero. Certainly can lean on the takedowns tonight if he needs to, but the knockout power has been a big part of the story with Yoel Romero. Protect your neck tonight. And a right punch followed by a left there by Romero. Immediately shoots for the leg. Bisping gets the early takedown. And Dizzy, as he looks to improve position here.
That's a nice clean shot. Excellent sweep. He lands a big shot from the bottom. Excellent movement on the ground here. Always trying to better his position. And he got mounted. Look at this. He's out of it. He's got half guard.
Landed that one. Nice elbow there.
Try. I can't get out. What the fuck?
Another elbow.
How do you escape this shit? Because when you get hit, you get it's hard to get out. The meter goes down.
I guess you gotta try to do it before you get hit.
Let's try. Oh, god damn it, I keep pushing start and shit.
Yeah, this thing.
Alright, we are underway here at the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, Nevada. So with 18 career wins by knockout or TKO, the UK's biggest mixed martial arts star by far. Oh!
What the fuck? I can't even touch you.
Look out for the arm. He's got his arm pinned down.
I win. I got more stamina than you.
It looks like the Kimura is locked in and tight for him.
Oh, we're getting a finish here.
Oh, no! He broke free!
Beautiful Kimura escape. And they're down on the ground. Inside the guard right away.
Well, that one should leave a mark. Outstanding leg kick employed there by Bisping. How about that shot? Nice flurry there by Romero.
Oh! Rocked him with that right hand.
He's got him hurt here. So heady stuff here with the takedowns. We'll see if he can execute here now on the ground.
Tagged him.
Under 2 minutes to go in our first round.
Nice. That one hurt.
And both guys really throwing with authority.
Damn, I'm out matched here. This is bullshit.
Better takedown artist in this featherweight division.
He hip escapes from the full mount. He's now working from side control again. He's doing a great job of moving and transitioning here on the ground. Now he's in half guard. Back to side control. He's gonna attack with a Kimura. He's got his arm pinned down.
We're done.
Got a very good Kimura. He might get a finish here.
This Kimura is very close. He might be forced to tap.
And there it is.
Stunning. And he really made it look easy. Round's about to end.
I don't get this game.
What happened?
In that submission and got the victory.
Yeah, you've got to admire the focus and the commitment to getting the finish. You could tell he was in hot pursuit of that submission. Now we go inside the octagon.
Yo, John, you can get this shit for $20 new at GameStop.
We are underway.
Really? Yeah.
So here is the future Hall of Famer and former UFC middleweight champion Michael Bisping, known primarily as a striker, but if he needs to go to the takedown, he is not afraid to do so, has some jiu-jitsu skills as well. Prevailing wisdom, though, is
I'm so all class. This is bullshit.
This could be it right here.
Fake Will Smith looking ass, trying to do some dead Suicide Squad shit.
For the leg.
Big hook to the head.
Well, Joe, I know he respects the power coming back, but it looked like he moved right into that kick to the body, and his opponent landed it flush. So let's see if he changes up his footwork a little bit and tries to avoid further damage to the midsection moving forward. How about that chin?
He's throwing.
Yeah, looks a little wobbly on his feet.
He's hurt.
Oh, big left. Massive head kick.
Here's a nice inside leg kick. Body kick, look at that.
There's the leg kick, that one checked by Bisping.
He's blocking almost all these shots. He's got to be careful here. He's in trouble.
Now goes in and secures the takedown. And just inches away from landing one of those big right hands.
Nice takedown. Inside control, tying up that arm, looking for the Kimura. He's got his arm pinned down. He's trying to finish it now. Could be it.
Final seconds here. Wow.
That Kimura looks nasty, and he's free. In full guard.
Second round, straight ahead.
I got saved, yeah.
So the round mercifully comes to an end. Multiple knockdowns there as
bigger
round.
Wow. Fucking garbage.
Second round underway.
Ah, I'm smart.
At the end of that round, his opponent was clearly hurt. He's going to look to start this round off fast and try to pick up where he left off. Yoel
is very relaxed until he explodes. And he has worked very hard on managing his energy inside the octagon. He tags it! Oh my goodness!
Well, he has landed some good shots tonight, Joe, but as yet, he has been unable to string together any solid combinations, and that has served to keep his opponent in this fight. So let's see if he can change up the tempo a little bit with his strike.
Damn it.